guys. Today on Offroad Subaru, we're gonna talk tires. I've been through a couple different sets. We started with the BFG Rugged Terrains, which were a good on-road tire, whatever. Then I went to the Discover AT3s, because I needed something a little bit more aggressive. Had some bad luck with these guys, so before I bought more of them, I decided to try something new, and went with the Atturo Trail Blade XTs. I'll tell you a little bit more about those, but first let's start with the three different ones. The Rugged Terrains, they, for a normal driver, for somebody that's doing, you know, some dirt roads, doing, you know, like fire roads, stuff like that, it's an amazing tire. It's quiet on the highway, it rides great, it's got good dirt road traction. I didn't really have much luck with it in the mud or anything like that. Obviously, I mean, it's just not that kind of a tire, but it's a good all-around tire for somebody that just needs a little bit more extra for the weekend. As you can see, it's not a very aggressive tread. It's you know, it's engineered to be kind of mainly straight use with a little bit of off-road situation. If you notice the tread blocks on the side here, there's almost nothing. There's nothing on the shoulder there. It's a nice transition, just like kind of what your regular road tire would be. Next we have the Discover AT3s. Now these, I ran these for about 5 months total. The best thing I'll say about them is they're quiet. They're really quiet for the amount of grip that you get. They have really good, I mean, snow traction. I went through the tail end of one winter, as well as the winter that we had here, which was almost nothing in Connecticut. The start of it. The issues that I have seen with this guy is mainly mud traction. It was good for a lot of other stuff, but when it gets wet, I mean, this tire for me, it just didn't work very well in the Subaru. The same with the Rugged Terrain. The really good thing about this is it's quiet. And if you need something that doesn't really add any NVH, which noise, vibration, harshness. I mean, this is a good selection, but you're going to take some compromises. It is a good all-around tire, as long as you're just wanting to do, like, state parks, whatever. I mean, for the thicker sidewall stuff, I mean, I would take it maybe some more aggressive stuff. I've tore two sidewalls, and as well as a tread off of one of them. I'll show you that a little bit later, as well as some other damage that I've noticed on the tires. And I personally don't feel confident running them because of all the problems that I've had. So I need to look for something different. And that's where we went to the Atturo Trail Blade XT. I got a full set. I ended up getting for the car and the trailer. 8 total. I mean, that's why I didn't want to buy 4 more ATs, AT3s from Cooper if I kept having problems with them. Since all the tires on the TC Teardrops off-road trailer, as well as the Subaru, all the same size, I decided just to go ahead and get a whole set. The thing about these, the only drawback is it does have road noise. I liken it to the KM2s, the new BFG, KO2s. They have about the same amount of road noise. These are a hair lighter by 4 or 5 pounds each than the KO2s. It's also a good tire for the budget-minded. It's $140, give or take, versus the $170 that I spent on the Coopers. And I've gone through 7 Coopers now, total. I've got, you know, the 5 that just came off the Subaru, as well as the 2 that I cut. And, I mean, it's a big investment if they can't hold up, you know? I've only had the Subaru for 9 months now, and I ruined 3 tires. I mean, it's not a good track record, in my opinion. But these guys, I've had these now for about a month and a half. I've taken them to Pennsylvania, to Bald Eagle State Forest once, and I've had pretty good results with them so far. Like I said, they are a bit noisier on the street, but in the muck stuff is where it really kind of shines. It's got nice huge lugs. It did really good through pretty much everything we threw at it. I mean, we were doing 20-25 inch deep water or so with, you know, thick layer ice on it. Other than a really bad line on my part that I had a winch out of, it did amazing. But short of going to 32s, it wouldn't have made a difference. I mean, there's only so much you can do with a 29-inch tire. The other thing is these are available in a 235, 65, 17, whereas the Rugged Terrains and the AT3s and the KO2s are a 245, 65, 17. Now, on a 5th-gen Outback, if you go 245, 65, in certain situations, at certain like loads, in reverse, at a certain steering, and you'll get a small amount of row on your mud flaps. It doesn't really affect anything. It is what it is. It's really negligible. It only happens under certain situations. But that also gives you a 29.5-inch tire, which is a hair closer to 30. Well, the 235 65 17, it actually eliminates all of that. It's a 29-inch tire, so that really small amount actually makes a difference. You get absolutely no rubbing. I've put all my mud flaps and stuff back on, and there's no rubbing because I wanted to make sure. And it's a really good handling tire. The other thing I noticed on like off ramps, on ramps, stuff like that, I can actually carry a little bit more speed with these versus the AT3s. I felt on that cusp that the AT3s were a little more wiggly, whereas these, they feel a little bit more planted. You can get a little bit more grip out of them, I guess you could say. They feel a little bit more confident at high speeds at the same PSIs. I run these at 38, put a tire temperature on it, and it's pretty even across. For longer trips, depending on you know, if I need the gas mileage, I'll pump it up to 40, 41. Then about the middle third-ish is what gets hotter, but there's still contact all the way around. But I don't really recommend it for longer distances, obviously, because you'll get uneven wear. But it is a good tire. Let me show you some of the little finer details of it compared to the AT3s. So here we have the Rugged Terrains, here we have the AT3s, and here we have the Atturo Blade XTs. You can see the huge difference, I mean, just in the tread blocks. The Rugged Terrain, you know, it's more like a passenger tire with, you know, a little bit more open clearing blocks that we can get stuff out. Whereas the AT3, you see it's got your siphoning for snow traction. Really good all-around tire. And then you can see the huge difference with the Atturos. There's huge lug blocks, nice clearing. It still has some siphoning for snow traction. Like I said, I didn't have any issues with it at all. It's got amazing clearing for mud, for sand. It's a good, more aggressive all-terrain. If you don't quite want a mud terrain, you want more of an all-terrain, but a little bit more aggressive, kind of like the KO2s. You have this option. It's significantly less expensive than the KO2s. It's in a perfect size for us 5th-gen guys, and for other cars, but obviously since I drive a 5th-generation Outback, I'm a little partial. Obviously I'm not a rock crawler, I'm a Subaru. But in instances where this would slip and I'd get more engagement of X mode in some other situations, I don't really have it with this. I'm attributing it to the bigger lugs and to the ability to clear all the wet mud or just massive stuff out of the way. That would be, you know, left in the tires, that would prohibit me from making up the obstacle. But we'll see. I mean, it is what it is. Let me show you a few issues that I've had with the AT3s. I'm going to show you some little tread issues that I've been finding. You see right there, right here, you have some separation of the tread block. See right there? I have it right here. See, there's some material missing there. You have some more there. And there also, that the tread blocks kind of just disintegrated. This is what they're supposed to look like. And you can see that they just start disappearing. So yeah, as you can see, I've had some issues with the AT3s. I mean, the places I took them, I mean, they went to the Vermont Over in a Rally, the Mid-Atlantic Orland Festival, as well as a few other situations. I mean, they performed, whatever. I had issues with them. I mean, they got me through everything. I didn't have to winch anything up there. It was all technical trails, but I mean, for the failure rate that I had to try something else. And since these just came out in this size, I mean, I figured, you know, it's a good fit. We'll see. But the Atturo Trailblade XTs are, so I mean, so far they haven't let me down. They've been through some not super crazy stuff, but for Subaru, I mean, they've gone through a lot of stuff that most guys wouldn't see. And for our chassis, I think it is a really good solution for an all-terrain tire. Like I said, there is a little bit of increased road noise. I mean, it is something to be aware of. I don't want to hide that fact. But past that, the grip is good. Snow traction's good. Didn't have any issues this last snow with getting up the hills of the house or anything like that. It functions. It is a really good tire, and I'm super happy with it. I definitely recommend it to anybody else. If you have any questions, email me at grant@offroadsubaru.com. I'll also have that down in the description. If you have any other questions, feel free to ask. Also check out offroadsubaru.com. All the stuff from the build from the Subaru, as well as the TC Teardrops trailer right here, is on the website. It's updated all the time. If you have a Subaru and you want to be featured, also hit us up on the contact page or contact us, and you know, we'll get the word out. You know, as long as you're out there having fun in your Subaru, that's all that matters. Have a good day, guys.